It took 9 months of war and some 6,000 people killed before a week-long truce came into effect. But already, the ceasefire in Yemen is in danger of collapsing, with each side accusing the other of violating the agreement. As the second day of peace talks ends in Geneva, fighters loyal to President Abd Rabu Mansur Hadi exchange gunfire with Houthi fighters in Taiz, Yemen's third largest city. Residents and tribal sources also report Saudi-led airstrikes on Houthi positions in two conflict zones, the latest in Riyadh's air campaign against the Iran-backed Houthis.
The Houthis are the ones that rejected the United Nations and Security Council resolutions and carried out attacks and struck residential homes and civilians, and we're just defending them. There are many civilian casualties. They even struck a hospital.
It was hoped the ceasefire between the Saudi-led coalition and the Houthis, coinciding with peace talks, would help finally end the civil war that's devastated this already impoverished country. A proposed prisoner swap of hundreds of Houthis and Yemenis, many of them between ages 13 and 16, had been one of the most positive signs yet in the conflict. But that too has been held up by armed tribesmen who are demanding that their relatives held by the Houthis also be included.